Hi, what's up guys, Raghu Sharma here, back with another video. Hope you all are doing well. So today in this video, I'll be telling you how to convert your wired CarPlay unit of your car to a wireless one using CPlay to car adapter. I really appreciate the concept of this dongle, as using cables can be really messy, and also we have to carry the cable every time from our home. Also, in this video, I will also try to use YouTube and watch video using this adapter to take it to its limits and check whether it can run YouTube wirelessly. And running YouTube means it has to stream video and audio at the same time. So this is the box of the CPlay to air adapter. So it says the features of it, and it says auto connection, free updates and all on the front of the box. The sides are pretty empty, and on the back it says some setup instructions, in which it tells us how to set up the device, some firmware update instructions and some troubleshooting instructions. So further ado, let's start the unboxing of this device. So this is the box, and here is my cutter, and I'll now remove this plastic cover from it so that I can peel it off and proceed to the opening of the box. So here I go, I have started peeling off this plastic, and I'll keep it aside, and I'll try to use the help of gravity to open this box. And here we go, we are inside. So just after opening the box, we can see the adapter itself and this user manual. In this user manual, it has all the same information which was outside the box about the setup, but it's a bit better as pictures are used over here. Other than that, on the back side, the same instructions are given in Chinese. Keeping it aside, now I'll take a look on this adapter itself, and taking it out, I can see it's quite light in weight and quite small in size, and there's nothing much other things inside the box. So this is the adapter. On it, it says CPlay to air, and this is the USB which goes into our USB of the car. It is in this glossy finish and currently covered with plastic. I'll keep it covered with plastic because I'll want it to stay away from scratches. So this is the USB port which can be used to update the firmware or connect the CarPlay using USB. Also, there were two LEDs which indicate the connection status of the device. So now let's go to our car and try the setup. So I'll firstly remove the old USB cable which I was using and keep it outside the car, and never ever will take it back inside again, and we'll plug the CPlay to air dongle inside. And I have also got this place to place it so that it gets hidden and is not visible to our eyes. So as soon as I did it, I can see this setup screen on the car's infotainment system, and using this instructions on the box, I will try to connect my device. So this is an iPhone 10 running iOS 14.4, and this is a rooted device, which means it has special permissions using Checkrain. You can also do it, and has CarBridge installed on it. So what CarBridge does is it can bridge any application which is on the phone into the CarPlay unit. So I have currently bridged YouTube application so that I can run YouTube on CarBridge. I have made a dedicated video on how to do that. You can check my video, the link will be provided in the description. So I have now turned on Bluetooth and Wi-Fi on my device, and as soon as I did it, I can see iPhone on the car's infotainment system. So I clicked it, and after that I can see this pairing prompt on my iPhone, and I'll click pair over here, and after that allow. Now another prompt is coming to use CarPlay, so I'll click use CarPlay, and I think we have set up the wireless CarPlay. It was that simple. So here it says connecting, and there we go, it's connected. So we are into CarPlay, as you can see. So now actually my phone is on 4G, and currently where I live, the 4G connection is not very well and the internet speed is a bit slow. That's why the map was not loading, and otherwise we can see the speed is pretty normal and just as it is using wires. Using maps, phone, music, everything is just normal as we have in wired connection. So as you can see, currently Wi-Fi is connected, and if I try to connect my home Wi-Fi, as the car is currently in the garage, I cannot connect it because the wireless CarPlay is using the Wi-Fi connection currently. So this is the technology of Apple, so I cannot complain. So currently with the maps which are opened are offered from CarBridge. So currently I'm opening the normal maps, and over here you can see it is working perfectly fine. And if I click on work, then it will load my work location and I can start the navigation. And here you can see the navigation is started just like normal, and I can recenter and do everything. I can exit the navigation at any point of time. Coming next, if I try to use music, it is also working fine and it's pretty smooth. The main point over here is the speed of the wired connection and this wireless connection is quite similar. I can say there is a bit lag of like 1 or 10 or 20 milliseconds, maybe I can say. That's the maximum gap I can say, not much than more than that, and that is quite negligible. One cannot notice that easily. And you can see I can change the settings and all. Everything is just like the wireless connection, no lag at all, and the device is also not heating at all. It is just as cold as it was earlier before switching it in. So now the main thing comes, that is watching YouTube. So I have installed YouTube using CarBridge, as I have told earlier also, so I will open it. If you want to install YouTube just like that, you can watch my video. The link will be provided in the description down below. So YouTube is currently turning on, and because of the slow cellular connection, it's a bit slow over here. So I'll search a video of mine. The video in which I have taught how to install CarBridge and use YouTube on CarPlay. So I'll write CarBridge iOS 14, and over here if I'll scroll down, I can see my video. It's not the top result, of course, my channel is not that big. So I'll scroll down a bit, and the third, fourth result will be my video. And this is my video, Raghav Sharma. So I'll open it. So now you'll see the video and the audio both. And here I'll do the full screen, and you can see the audio is coming now. There's a bit a lag between audio and video, about 2 second lag of audio. Video comes first and audio comes late, 2 seconds, I don't know why. Currently you can see that the CarPlay modem is connected, no wire is connected. This is just connected to the car and no wire is connected to the phone. The phone is currently connected with Wi-Fi and YouTube is running wirelessly using this CPlay 2 car dongle, and YouTube is running through CarBridge. So you can see so much of technology right going here. I don't know why the video can come first and audio is in delay. I think audio comes through Bluetooth or something, because of that there is 2 second delay, and this video is coming through Wi-Fi. I think something sort of that is happening. So now let's try the auto connect feature. So here I have come into the car from outside and I have turned on the start stop button of the engine, and you can see, voila, we have got the CarPlay just directly as soon as we have entered. So now I'll connect a non-rooted device, which is an iPhone 12. I thought this is important because many users will be non-rooted, and hence this should be shown so that you can get an idea how it works and don't have a doubt like if the jailbreak one is faster or like something. So this is an iPhone 12 running the latest software to on this date, which is 14.6, and I have connected it through Wi-Fi using this CPlay 2 Air chip or dongle, whatever we can say. And you can see the performance is very nice. Everything is running fluidly, seamlessly, and just like what it is on the wire. Now I have an observation here that if we turn off the Bluetooth, the display is still working, the CarPlay is still working, but if we turn off the Wi-Fi, it stops working. Now it can be like that the Bluetooth is the one which supplies the audio to it, and the Wi-Fi is the one which supplies display to it. So I have turned off, I'll turn off the Wi-Fi over here. So here I turn it off, and as soon as I do it, you can see the screen gets freezed and it stops working. and it comes back to the setup screen. So this can be a possibility. So now I also had this old iPhone 6 running iOS 12. So people might be there which are using iOS 12. So I thought I should make add this also, that how iOS 12 turn out while using CarPlay with this dongle. So there's nothing much installed on my phone, and hence there's only the single page over here. And if I try to open phone or anything else, it's working just normal. There's a bit of lag because the phone is quite slow itself. It's quite old and there's problem in the battery. But other than that, there is no performance issue when the app opens, and everything is working just like if I would have used wire. So I think the thumbs up for that CPlay to Air company has managed to get this type of performance over the air, like wirelessly, which wire provides. So I am quite impressed from them, and for now my dongle is working quite good. So now let's cover how to firmware update this dongle. So firstly, we have to connect a wire to this USB port on the dongle and the other end to our iPhone. So now what this does is it connects to the display with wire. So currently the performance which it will be showing is the one with wire, like we are forcing it to be connected with wire, not wirelessly. After connecting to wire, we have to open the supplied URL. But when I tried to do that, it was not opening. Now this can be because this phone doesn't have SIM and it requires a network connection. So I tried using a different phone which had SIM, and when I used it, the site loaded and it says it has the latest version installed. So coming to the Android connection, we can also connect an Android device to it using this USB cable. We'll plug in the USB cable in the USB port of the dongle and the other end to our phone. Now we have to install this Drawing Screen app on our phone before continuing. So I have connected the USB wire. Now you can see there is a pop-up on the phone where it says we have the Drawing Screen app will handle the requests. And we'll now click start now by giving the permissions. Now what will it do is it will screen mirror the phone. Android Auto will not work this way. If you want to use Android Auto, you have to remove the dongle and put the USB directly into the port. But if you can manage with this screen mirroring, or you like this, then you can go with this. Now what happens here is you cannot use the phone from the touchscreen of your car's infotainment system, but you have to use it from the phone itself. You have to open the Maps app and use the commands given from the phone. The infotainment system will just work as a screen. Now let's conclude the video. I really like this product. This product is just amazing. The performance of this product is very good, and it is very promising. What it says, the features written on it just matches what it does. It is quite good. It can even handle YouTube, which I have just showed you in the video. So I really recommend this product to you. If you can spend $129, then I can say you should go for it. This is really a good deal, as it can change the whole experience of CarPlay on your car. You can just enter the car and it will connect it, and there will be no hassle like carrying the USB cable and putting it inside the car, hiding it all the time and all. So I think this product is quite good, and I'll recommend it to you. You can buy this product. I'll try to put the link of the product in the description. I have bought this product directly from the CPlay 2 Air website, and it delivered directly from the China warehouse. Thanks for watching my video. I hope it helped you. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel.